Welcome to NYC.com.
You can call me 1 take.
Woo!
Yeah, I'm back. I do this to touch souls. I ain't trying to be famous. 1 in a billion. Y'all know who the name is. Get a picture, you can frame it. Next to Big and Pac is one of the greatest. I'm dangerous, like little kids talking to strangers. I'm going to the UN screaming out Cana. My pop's hardcore, he was born in a manger. Me, born in a Brooklyn elevator. I'm so serious, they call me something major. You need me like clothes and closet need hangers. On Venice, they flocked at me like I was a Laker. Multiple businesses and they all making paper. Multi-millionaires, they owing me favors. They like, you need some? I'm like, nah, maybe later. My chick thick dog, they call her a caker. What can I say, man? I'm blessed with favor.
Watch out!
AP, welcome to NYC.com, welcome to NYC Television. I have a surprise guest with me, and his name is?
Isaiah Morton, a.k.a. The Gift.
Okay, why did they call you The Gift?
Because I'm multi-talented in all aspects.
Okay, well, out of your talents, we've seen some of your basketball skills on Welcome2nyc.com, and people have been hitting it up like crazy. Like, what's good with that? Where you get those skills?
My family, everyone has something good that they do, and I put it all together and put it in my game. And once I do that, it's hard to stop all my family combined in one person.
Oh,
so my first buzzer beater of my high school career. Once it went in, I knew it was going in. I was just happy that we won the game. We played them again. Hopefully, I didn't need another buzzer beater, but we played well. So,
how'd you do that game?
I played well. I had 31 points. I think 7 assists, 7 rebounds. I played pretty good, and we won.
Doing your thing with ball for a long time now. It seems like a long time. You're still young. You're still in high school now, but I remember way back. For one, this is my nephew right here. This is The Gift, if y'all don't know by now. And I remember when he was just like 10, 11 years old, we went out to Atlanta for All-Star Weekend. I mean, you got to be a part of that. Like, how was that experience?
That experience, yeah, I still have memories about that experience. I remember everything from the long drive there to the long drive back, to the girl hitting the ball off my head. It was just a great experience, meeting great people. Atlanta was real, real good, and people still hearing about it to this day. And I'm a lot older now, so.
The way it seems is like anytime a ball is in your hands, you've been destined for like stardom. I remember that experience with you in Atlanta. Then I remember you went to the basketball camp, the ABCD camp, right?
Yeah.
And I mean, you just was just a spectator in the crowd. Tell them exactly what happened when you went there.
We were going to watch, I believe, LeBron James play and Sebastian play. And I just took the ball and just started like dribbling around. As a young kid, I always had a ball with me. I still do all the time. I was just dribbling around, exhibitioning my dribbling skills. And then everyone stopped watching LeBron and Sebastian play, and they came to watch me play. And then I went to go play against Jason Williams, who was an NBA star, but he got hurt in an accident. So we played one-on-one, and everybody that was watching LeBron James play, who is probably arguably the best player in the NBA right now, and he was watching me and him play one-on-one. So that was a great experience.
That's crazy. So it's like, that's what I'm saying. It's like everywhere you go, you like destined for stardom, man. Like, does that put a lot of pressure on you, or do you enjoy it? Like,
I enjoy it a lot. I think it's just God, man, because everything in my life is, it seems like it's a coincidence, man. So many signs, so many people told me that I'm destined to make it, and it's just me having confidence and keeping humble, and I know I will make it one day.
That good stuff. So another experience. I mean, because so much has been going on with you that sometimes we forget. I remember Little Mama, her hottest song ever, her lip gloss popping song. How do you end up getting that?
What you know about me? What you know?
Well, I had an IS8 game. That's one of the biggest tournaments out. And our game got canceled because they were having a video there. So the video producers, they needed basketball players. So I was there. So they asked me if I wanted to be in it. I said, sure, why not? Little did I know she would become the superstar that she is now. And that's basically it, what happened there.
That's crazy. I mean, it's like experience after experience. And I could keep naming it different experiences, different things that have gone on with you and your life and so many celebrities that you already know. I'm gonna say, aside from basketball, you being able to have access to all these celebrities, what else are you looking to do with your life?
Make music, making my own business if basketball doesn't work out for me. I know with all the connections I got in my school, St. Augustine Prep, which is a great school, multi-million dollar businesses are in my school. I could join anything that I want to right now because of the decisions that my parents and I have made in life. I met so many people where I could go so many different ways, especially with yourself. This music thing, this will be working for me, basketball working for me. There's so much things I can go.
I hear that, Gucci. Y'all gotta hear some of his tracks. So his tracks is fire. Actually, y'all have heard some of his music because you heard AP, you heard SK on some of his stuff, but you know what I mean? Now we got the whole connection going from the East Coast to the West Coast, and y'all gonna hear big things from him.
Right now, there's a bunch of colleges that are open interested in me, but I'm open. I'm just trying to play my hardest this summer and see what happens from there. A lot of Pac-10 schools out west, Big East schools, Seton Hall, Rutgers, Villanova, just to name a few, Stanford, UCLA, Oregon, schools like that, and schools by me, St. Joe's, LaSalle, Holy Cross, Siena, schools like that, so.
Okay, that's cool.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, are you leaning more towards staying on the East Coast where you're close to your family or traveling and going to a different location?
I have family everywhere, so if I go West Coast, I'll be out with my family out there. If I go to East Coast, all my immediate family is here. So it's basically a decision of like where I like, where, like the style of play. And possibly if I go out West, then my family could come out and watch me play. Or if I come out to East, my family could do the same thing there.
All right, I just want to ask you, at your height in ball, like, when you see a guy like Nate Robinson playing against taller guys and winning slam dunk contests, how does that make you feel?
It proves that guys my size, we could do it all, man. I just try to strive for perfection on the basketball court because I can't make mistakes that other guys can do, like big guys. They can make a couple mistakes. But as a point guard at my size, you have to be almost perfect in order to make it into high Division I and the pros.
Once again, this is your dude AP, Welcome2nyc.com, Welcome2nyc Television, and we signing out. Make sure everybody, you vote for the motto of the week on Welcome2nyc.com, and vote for who's your favorite artist on Welcome2nyc.com. And anybody that's looking to get their music heard, we have top A&Rs from Capitol Records, Universal, Def Jam, all looking to hear your music on Welcome2nyc.com. So AP, and I'm with the gift, Isaiah Morton, signing out.
Welcome to NYC.